So we use prescribed fire to help mimic a natural cycle. So fires in this environment would have come in through every 2 to 5 years, maybe every 5 to 15 years. So that cycle would have reduced the amount of fine fuels, heavy fuels on the ground, lifted crowns of the trees, and basically make it to where the system responds favorably when there's a fire. So with fire, we create a system that's healthier for the long term. So for each burn, we have specific objectives we're trying to meet. Remove this amount of vegetation, or top kill these trees or these plants. Long term, we're looking at much bigger topics like sustainability and resilience and increase in biodiversity. So when we talk about prescribed fire, we have single events with goals, but then we have a series of prescribed fires that's a program that gets our system where we want it to be. A system that's resilient to change, whether that's floods, droughts, or wildfires. A system that's diverse, so it has a diversity of plants that are enjoyable to the public, and also palatable and important to the species that depend on this system. So those are two of the concepts we're trying to meet, is the sustainability and resiliency, as well as the diversity of the system long term.
Hey Greg, this is Glenn Gilman, Travis County Parks. Wanted to let the dispatch office know that we're going to be burning today.
You can plant a bunch of stuff in a garden, but the likelihood that you grow what you envision or what was on the package is really low unless you work hard to make it happen. So you have to have a vision of what you're going to do. You have to work for that vision. And that means maybe reducing competition, plucking weeds. It might mean adding fertilizer. It might mean increasing the amount of water or decreasing the amount of water. All those are going to be decisions and actions you have to do, and I think the same with land management. This is how we can tend a much bigger garden. So we can't go out there and trim around every tree or fertilize every tree, but we can decide what we want that landscape to look like, and we can make determinations about how much we can invest in it. So prescribed fire is a way to invest in a big area. So we can say today we're going to go out and we're going to do all those activities on this 70 acres. So we're going to fertilize it today because we'll burn through that grass and that will release raw nutrients back into the soil. We will do our weeding today because we are making determinations about some of those shrub plants. We have more than we need, so we're going to remove some, and that will make the ones that we leave more resilient and stronger. Those grass plants that we have top killed will resprout, so we'll make some determinations about provide more planting areas, I guess, for some species. So the grasses will probably decline for a few years and we'll see a whole different set of flowering plants come up instead. So yeah, I think it's really large scale landscaping, really a broad brush. We can't get down to the detail of what's going to happen to any one plant. We have to work on percentages, like 10% of the plants will be a top kill today. We don't know which exactly those will be, but we're not going to top kill them all. Some will survive just like they currently are. So yeah, it's really just us making a decision we're going to do something, because again, going back to the garden, if you don't do things, that's a decision. So things are going to go some direction, and we've all had a garden that went the direction we didn't want it to. And that was usually because we didn't have a good vision, didn't have the resources to implement it, and couldn't sustain it.
Yeah, just checking on you guys. We're up on the hill looking at your smoke. Looks like just one little pocket. Down low, just kind of seeing, is that where that meadow is that's down the slope?
It's a long-term commitment. So if we're going to use fire, we're not going to change the system in one fire event. It's going to take multiple fire events, and we'll have to refine them over time. But ideally, at some point, you get the system to where it's more of a maintenance fire, so the fires are, it's easier to identify burn windows because you don't need as extreme weather events or hot conditions to do what you need to do. You're doing just a very light weeding. It's kind of similar to a garden. If you pluck plants every day, then you never have to weed heavily. We'd like to get to that point with our projects, to where it's just a simple routine project. The fuel loads are never high. The burn units and the burn lines are always well defined and ready. So it just becomes a routine event. You know, we're really working on fire every day to some degree throughout the year. Either we're getting equipment ready, we're building fire lines, we're writing plans, we're constantly moving our landscapes forward, not exclusively with fire, but predominantly with fire, because again, it's a cost-effective, broad-scale treatment that we can apply. And again, our goal is to burn or treat 10% of our landscape a year, and prescribed fire is the most effective way to get to that number. But there's other tools we'll use and do use. We will start within the next month, kind of identifying what we're going to do next year. But we've already kind of got an idea, because what we do this year, we want to support next year. So what we do this year should make next year easier.
So it will reduce forest fires or wildfires in this local immediate area. So what we find is after multiple fire treatments, the crowns are lifted, so it takes a much more extreme fire to impact the crowns. And that's what we really want to do, is make sure that these systems last forever. So grasses respond favorably to fire. That's why you can mow them, because they don't mind if you remove the top part of the vegetation. But trees typically don't respond favorably to fire. So we want a fire to come through, remove the ground fuels, leave the canopies, and make them stronger for the next event.
My favorite part of burning is actually coming out after the event and seeing all the great change. That's my most rewarding part of it.